Your mind that you consider yours is not yours. Your mind is borrowed. The mind is within you, but it is really a projection of the society inside you. It is not yours. No child is born with a mind. Here I am using the word mind not for the mechanism which is brain. Brain is a mechanism and mind is a collection of many things, the memory, the past, the conditionings and all that. The child is born with a brain. Brain is a mechanism and mind is an ideology. And there is a vast difference between mechanism and ideology. The brain is fed by the society and then it creates a mind according to its own condition. That is why there are so many minds in the world. Hindu mind is certainly separate from the Christian mind, and the communist mind is different than the Buddhist mind. But the fallacy is created in the individual that mind is yours. So every individual starts acting according to the mind, but indirectly he starts operating or following the society, but feeling as if he is functioning on his own. And this is a cunning device. Gurdjieff used to tell a story. A magician deep in the mountains had many sheep. To avoid servants and to avoid looking after the sheep and going in search for them every day when they were lost in the forest, he told each sheep different stories. He gave different minds to each sheep. To one he told, "You are not a sheep, you are a man. So you need not be afraid that one day you will be killed, sacrificed like other sheep. They are only sheep, so you need not be worried as far as returning home is concerned." To some he said, "You are a lion, not a sheep." And to some, "You are a tiger." And since that day, the magician was at ease. The sheep started behaving according to the mind that was given to them. He could kill a sheep every day. He used to kill sheep for his own food and that of his family. The sheep who believed that they were lion or men or tiger would simply look and giggle. This is what happens to sheep. But they were not afraid like in the old days. When he killed a sheep before, all the sheep were trembling. "Afraid, tomorrow is going to be my day. How can I live?" And that is why they used to escape in the forest to avoid the magician. But now nobody was escaping. There were tigers, there were lions, all kind of minds had been implanted in. Your mind is not yours. This is something basic to be remembered. If you remember that, the process of transformation can begin. Your mind is an implantation of the society in which you have accidentally been born, the family in which you are accidentally being born. The birth in most of the cases is accidental. It is only the awakened one, he decides which family or which place he will take the birth. If you were born in a Christian home but immediately transferred to a Mohammedan family and brought up by Mohammedans, you would not have the same mind. You would have a totally different mind that you cannot conceive of. Bertrand Russell, one of the genius of our times, tried hard to get rid of the Christian mind. Not because it was Christian, but simply because it was given to him by others. He wanted his own fresh outlook about things. Yesterday there were some people, they asked, how is your name, Taosha Buddha? I said, all other names are given by others. The family name is given by the parents, but that name has stuck in one way. As far as my official records are concerned, that name is stuck in the passport that I have to carry on until I am alive. The name that was stuck in certificates, that is finished because I have no more proof of my education. Illiterate as far as certificates are concerned. Then there was a name that was stuck because of the business. Taosha Buddha is the name that I have given to be known as according to the inner growth. So Bertrand Russell wanted to get rid of the Christian mind because that was given to him by others. He wanted his own fresh outlook about things. He did not want to see from somebody else's glasses. He wanted to come in contact with reality immediately and directly. He wanted his own mind. So it was not a question of being against Christian mind. If he had been a Hindu, he would have done the same. If he had been a Mohammedan, he would have done the same. If he had been a communist, he would have done the same. The question is whether the mind is yours or implanted by others. Because the others implant a mind in you which does not serve you. Instead, it serves the purpose for which it has been. Now, in the whole Soviet Union, every child is being brought up with a communist mind. So is the case in China. One, I heard a person who was visiting Soviet Union. He went to see a school and he asked a small child, "Do you believe in God?" The boy looked at him in shock and said, "At your age, in this century, you ask such question. In the past, when people were ignorant, they used to believe in God. There is no God." Now this child will believe for his whole life. This is his voice. It is not so. It is the voice of the society instead. It serves the purpose of the vested interest of the society. You are prepared by the parents, by the teachers, by the priest, by your educational system to have a certain kind of mind. And your whole life, you go on living through that certain kind of mind. This is borrowed life. And that is why there is so much misery in the world, because nobody is living authentically. Nobody is living in his own self, is simply following the orders implanted in him. Bertrand Russell tried hard and wrote a book, Why I Am Not a Christian. But in a letter to his friend he wrote, "Although I have written the book, although I do not believe that I am a Christian, I have dropped that book, still deep down. One day I ask myself, who is the greatest man in history? Rationally I know it is Gautam Buddha, but I could not put Gautam Buddha before Jesus Christ because the conditioning was very deep. That day I felt that all my efforts have been futile. I am still a Christian. I know rationally that Jesus stands no comparison with Gautam Buddha, but it is only rational. Emotionally, sentimentally, I cannot put Gautam Buddha above Jesus Christ. Jesus remains in my unconscious is still affecting my attitude, my approaches, my behavior. The world thinks that I am no longer a Christian, but I know. It seems difficult to get rid of this mind. They have cultivated it with such acumen, with such craftsmanship. And this is a long process. If you look deep into yourself, you think you have abandoned Christianity or the religion that you were born in, and you are listening to these talks, you are reading, are you really disowned the mind that you was conditioned in? And it is a long process. You never think about it. A man lives at the most 70, 75 years. And for 25 years, he had to be in schools, colleges, university. One third of life is devoted to cultivating a certain mind. Bertrand Russell failed because he had no knowledge of how to get it, how to get rid of this mind. He was fighting but groping in darkness. There are absolutely certain meditation, certain methods of meditation which can take you away from the mind. And then it is very easy if you want to drop it. But without first becoming separate from the mind, it is impossible to drop it. Who is going to drop and whom? Bertrand Russell is fighting with one of his mind against the other. Both are Christian. It is impossible, and now it has been proved scientific. One of the most important scientific contribution is from Mystic Delgado. He has found 700 centers in brain. Each center is capable of containing an immense quality of knowledge. It is just like recording. He was a scientist, but I call him a mystic because he had a mystical approach. And his experiments are very shocking. He touches a certain center in the brain with an electrode and the man starts speaking. He takes away the electrode and the man stops. He puts the electrode back on the same center and the man starts speaking again from the very beginning. Delgado himself has not been able to figure out how the tape gets reversed, because the man always starts from the very beginning. Wherever you leave him makes no difference. It is not that he starts where you left him. Some automatic process in the mind will be discovered. Some electrodes can be implanted in the mind permanently, and it can be controlled from far away by remote controls. This he exhibited in Spain in a bullfight. He planted an electrode in the mind of the toughest bull, and he stood in the field showing a red flag. The bull pushed towards him furiously and the people almost stopped breathing. The bull is going to kill one of the best geniuses, but they did not know that he had a remote control switch in his pocket, just a small box in the switch. And when the bull was about to attack from 1 foot away, he pushed the button and the bull stopped, just frozen. And he did it many times. Again and again the bull came with the same ferocity, and again he stopped whenever Delgado pushed the button. He says sooner or later this discovery can either become a blessing to humanity or it can become a curse. Every child's mind can be easily implanted with an electrode. You will have very obedient people. You will not have any rebels. You will not have any revolutionaries, but the whole charm of the life will be gone. People will be simply vegetables, enslaved scientifically, and they will not know because the remote control unit may be in the capital, in the hands of the government, can be useful. Criminals can be implanted, murderers can be prevented, thieves can be changed, rapists can be transformed, but it is very dangerous. Anybody who is in power can make the whole country just a crowd of slaves, and you cannot do anything because you do not know. Remember one, inside the skull where the brain is, you do not have any sensitivity. Even if a stone is put inside your skull, you will never know. You just do not have sensitive nerves there which can inform you. This came to be known during the Second World War. A man was shot with a bullet, and somehow the doctors thought that the bullet was not inside him but had missed, but touching his head. So they treated the wound, it healed, and the bullet remained inside his brain for 10 years. And he was never aware of it. It was for some other reason that he was being examined, x-rayed, and they were surprised to find that there was a bullet inside him. Then the wound was opened and the bullet was found. That made it clear that anything can be implanted in the mind. Although Delgado's mechanism is scientific, but the society has been doing the same by implanting ideas inside. It is an old bullock cart method. It takes so long, nearly 25. You enter universities, you spend 25, 30 years of your precious life in university campuses. And when you come out, you are given honors and degrees that now you are ready to plunder into the world that lies ahead of you. But does the university education prepare you for the simple question that life asks you? Day-to-day simple questions. If not, that there is something wrong in the education system. It has taken away something. And it is good that there are people who escape from the enslaving structure of the society, because these are the people who have advanced knowledge, who have given all scientific progress, who have changed all superstitions. But the society wants you to be a carbon copy, never an original. The strategy to create a mind in you is to go on repeating certain things continuously in the same way. And even if a lie is repeated continuously, it starts becoming a truth. This is what the magician did by giving certain information to each one of the sheep. And if a lie is repeated continuously, it starts becoming a truth. You forget that it was a lie in the beginning. Adolf Hitler started lying to German people that all the misery of their country is because of the Jews. Now this is such an absurdity, like somebody saying that all the misery of the country is because of the bicycles. So if we destroy all the bicycles, all misery will disappear. You always remember the problems you have been told, conditioned, that all the problems in your life is because of the other. And we live with this. And we are never able to get rid of the problems in life. Your problem with the spouse is not because of you, but it is because of the other. Isn't it so? You consider, you are not dealing good with your neighbor. It is not because of you, but because of your neighbor. You are not getting along well with your mother or father. it is because of there is something lacking in them. They are not able to understand. All our problems is because of the others. In fact, Jews were the very backbone of Germany. They had created all the wealth of Germany, and they had no other nation. So any nation, wherever they were, was their nation. They had no other alternative in their minds. They could not betray, and they had been doing all that any other German was doing for the welfare of the country. But Hitler, in his autobiography, writes, "It does not matter what you say, because there is no such thing as truth. Truth is a lie that has been repeated so many times that you have forgotten that it is a lie." So it is. So the only difference, according to him, between truth and lie is that lie is fresh and truth is old. Otherwise, there is no difference. And he seems to have insight in it. For example, Christianity, Hinduism, Mohammedanism, these three religions repeat to their children, there is a God. Jainism, Buddhism, Taoism, three other religions say there is no God. The first group of three religions have a certain mind. Their whole life is filled with the idea of God, hell, heaven, prayer. The second group of three religions has no prayer, because there is nobody to pray to. There is no God, and the very question does not arise. Now, half of the world is communist. They do not believe even in the soul of the man. And every child is continuously told that man is matter. And when man dies, he simply dies. And nothing remains, there is no soul. Consciousness is a byproduct. Now, half of the humanity repeats it as truth. This is what Adolf Hitler preached and continued. This way he continued.